everyone. We all know it's important to work out and get exercise, but do you pay the price the next day? Zehra has some tips to prevent muscle soreness and what to do if you do end up with aches and pains after a workout. Hey, Zehra, how are you?
I'm good, Tracy. How are you?
I am great. Now, I see you getting down with your kids all the time, and I'm sure there are parts of the body that must be sore afterwards. So let's start maybe with the warm-up, because you say that's really crucial before you do anything, right?
Yes, definitely. So I know a lot of us have been home, and I think we're at a part where we're like, okay, I need to get up and move. And so you're watching videos on YouTube, or you're trying to join some workout program or dust out those weights that you found, and we get right into it and you're feeling sore the next day. And it's probably because you're not warming up properly. Those muscles are just kind of like, oh, so we're doing this. So it's really important to warm up. And the reasons are it gets your blood flowing, which is really important, right? Like slowly, gradually, we're like a car starting up in the cold, right? Yeah. It gets your muscles loosened up, and especially doing warm-ups that you are doing that are going to be similar to the exercise that you're doing. It's getting blood flow to those muscles, and it's also getting that brain-body connection. So it's just getting your brain sending pathways to the muscles that you're working, so you're getting used to those movements and you're less likely to get injured.
Okay, all really good points. What do you suggest as a few warm-ups that we should incorporate?
Yeah, so when you're warming up, a lot of people think about stretching. It's really important to do dynamic stretches. And what that means is stretches where you're moving. So you don't want to hold a stretch because, again, your muscles aren't super warm. So you don't want to hold something and try to pull something. You want to make sure that you're warming up gradually. So I've got a band here, and I think you do too. And even just using something to help your body stretch out. So even just something like this to just loosen up the shoulders, it's really, again, we're sitting all day, we're in one hunched position. So really important to just open up the shoulders, warm up those muscles. So what it's doing, it's sending blood to the muscles we're moving. Those muscles are waking up, warming up. And then you can even just do a side stretch, and using something can sometimes help you to just get a little bit deeper in those stretches and see how it's a nice fluid motion.
It feels so good, Zehra.
It does.
Oh, I actually really, really look forward to my warm-up every single day. Sometimes I like it more than the workout, I'm not going to lie, because it does wake up the brain and the body. Feels great. Okay,
We've
warmed up properly. What else do we need to know if we go hard and then we have some muscle soreness? What can you show us?
Okay, so after your workout, that's when it's important to cool down, practice your mobility. And you want to think of your body as like an elastic band, right? So when it's cold, it's more likely to snap, right? So when it's warm, you can stretch it out a little bit. So that's when you want to do like your deep stretches. You want to, you know, make sure you're using, and you can also use things like a foam roller, right? To really get out those, it's like a massage, right? We can't go anywhere. So it really just helps flush out that lactic acid. It's just like giving a massage to your muscles, getting that blood flowing, and it can really help with recovery after your workout if you're sore.
What else can you show us in terms of mobility that might help us recover from soreness?
You can use your own body weight, but you can also add things like using little balls like this, finding the spot where you're tight and kind of moving around that place in your body where you feel that tightness and holding it there. A lot of times we have to learn to listen to our body. So if your hips are tight, make sure you're stretching out those hips. Get a little bit deeper each time. Mobility is really important as you see improvements. Just like you notice you can lift heavier weights, you want to be able to get more of a range of motion and feel more comfortable in those movements. And that helps increase your mobility and you'll be less likely to injure yourself.
Ooh, I love that little ball. I'm doing a lot of rolling out of the glutes from an injury from last year that I didn't take care of properly. So, now it's a matter of catching up and trying to break away some of that scar tissue. But rolling those out,
it feels so good.
Such
a nice feeling.
Yeah, it's a great feeling.
Feels so good. And do it against, like, the wall or the ground, so you have that like something hard to push up against, and it hurts. It's like that good hurt. You're like, ah, and then you hold it and then you feel that release. It's really good to have these do while you're watching TV or something, but it's a great way to stretch out those muscles.
Do it while you're watching Cityline, everyone. Zehra, thank you so much for those tips. Really
exactly.
Good getting us feeling loose and feeling good.